Hey guys, for this intermediate video of logo art, I'm just going to show you how to create the Minecraft text. You can see that I've obviously made it a little bit three-dimensional by adding those diagonal lines so that it's striking and it makes it look like it's coming off the page. Alright, so first of all, get the Minecraft logo up in front of you, and then you can analyse how I have already analysed some of those letters and how they are shaped. So with the M, I've dropped it down, so instead of just the diagonal line for an M, which you'd normally have, I've just given it those really straight vertical and horizontal lines. And then in the middle of the A, and that A, I've just added that little Minecraft face. I think it's a face. I've just added that little face there, and then on all the letters, I've just added that really faint little scratchy line so that it looks like it's smashed brick. All right. So I'm just going to show you how I started. So first of all, you're just going to need a normal drawing pencil, so that is an HB pencil, and you're just going to draw out those guidelines that I always bang on about. And then you're going to break your name up however you want. So if your name was Mark, you would then break it in half and then break that in half again. So Mark is obviously four letters. So if you've got your rectangle, and then I've got 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, I can already see that that one is just slightly smaller than that one. So I can analyze that before I've put my letters in. So that's really good, because obviously now I just know to make my M a little bit bigger. All right, but first of all, what I am going to do is I'm just gonna make sure that middle line is straight, but then the letters are just slightly leaning in. Okay? Like so. All right, so they're all leaning towards the middle. So instead of just doing your M downwards, you're going to do it on a bit of an angle, like so. And remember, push it right up to that line, and every line should be parallel to that line. And then again for the A, I'm just going to make sure that it kind of comes up on an angle there, but then on that side it's going to be straight because it's going into the middle. So you can already see that it's starting to come to life there. You can see the letters in the style of Minecraft, can't you? And then the R, I'm going to push it right up to there, but then of course it's going to cut in there. Try and keep it all this as well in the same line if you can. So I'll push that M up a little bit, push that R down a bit, sorry, the A down a bit, and I'll push the R down a bit, okay? And then the R is just a nice simple line like so. And then the C, I'm just going to have it pushed right up to there. So now that I've finished the letters, you can see the name Mark. What I'm going to do now is I'm just going to add that little shape. I think it's a face. Please correct me if I'm wrong, but so there we go. So there's the actual name. Now what we're going to do is we're just going to draw another line here. So it looks like those letters are coming out. All right, so what we're going to do is every line, we're just going to draw coming out of that center. Okay, so imagine that the center is straight, and then coming out on the right, it's just slightly diagonal there. And I'm just going to do the same for that. And then that M there would still be parallel like that, just slightly behind that one. And then this one is a little bit different because I'm just going to make it a little bit thinner at the bottom so that this one can be straight-ish, all right? And now obviously with the A, we're gonna have to pull it up there. And then the M, push it up like that. And then that C, just stays the same. Apart from there, we pull it down like that, and then the ear. All right, so there's your name. So now what we're gonna do is we are just gonna rub out all of our guidelines and any sketchy kind of edge that you've got, and just make sure that you can see where you're happy with the lines. Okay, and then just slightly rub it out as well, you know, so we've just got the line. All right, so what I'll do is I'll show you how to completely complete one letter, and then all the other letters you can just kind of go your own way. Okay, so I'm just going to use here a 6B pencil. If you haven't got a 6B, if you've got something slightly lighter like a 2B or whatever, it still works. And what you're going to do is you're just going to slightly just put that turn in there on the edge of every part of the letter, and then you are going to use a blending stump. All right, if you don't have a blending stump, like I said, use a Q-tip or a cotton bud or something like that, and you're just going to blend it in. So can you see now I've got that motion where it's going from dark to light, all right? And then obviously the base where it's zooming out, that's going to be slightly darker. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to start every single shape like that, all right? And then start again, and then start again. Just, you can see that I'm just starting every single shape again. And then there, and then inside the letter, it would be really dark, like so, and like so. So you can see that's quite messy. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to get my blending stub, and I'm just going to smooth it all out. So you can see now that I've got all that tone in there, and then I'm just going to take my fine liner or my Sharpie, whatever you've got. Here you can see that I've got, okay, get it, just a normal biro. So I'll show you how it looks in biro, and then I'll go over the top of it with Sharpie. All right, so I'm just going to make sure that each edge of the letter is just slightly curved, because remember, as much as it is a rock, I'm just going to slightly curve it so that it looks like those Minecraft letters that you see on the video game front cover and in the video game. And again, going back to the previous video where I create the Friends logo, just remember that these look really good on the front of a sketchbook at the beginning of the year, whatever year you're in. Okay, so there is it with a biro edge. Now, I'm just going to show you with a fine liner. It's just slightly neater, can you see that? You see, it's just a lot neater, isn't it? And now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to ever so slightly just scratch into it with vertical and horizontal lines going along the M, like so. Just missing out those little gaps, okay? Just like that. And then lastly, I'll just show you what it looks like when you emphasize the actual letter with a Sharpie. Because the actual logo of Minecraft is very, very striking. So the reason that I use a Sharpie is just so that the actual letter itself really stands out, okay? And then just go around the edge of each shape, like so. You see? So I think personally the Sharpie works a lot better. And then obviously, once you've gone around every single letter like this, just give me 1 minute. The only thing is though, when you rush, it does look quite scruffy. So obviously this video is about 10 minutes long, so this logo should really take you about 25 minutes, maybe 30 minutes to do. But it's worth it because it's on the front of your book, all year, or if you're a GCSE student, obviously for 2 years. There you go. So you can see that that's obviously how you would have those bubble letters. And then if you wanted to, you could add a little line around it. That's how I've done it. And again, I'm rushing. Please make sure that all these lines are parallel, horizontal, vertical, absolutely perfect. And then if you don't rush and you take your time, it looks quite smart like that. So what I'm going to do is I'm again, just like the last video where I did the Friends logo, I'm just going to show you how it looks on the front of a book so that you could have that in school. And if you wanted to, again, just take some large scissors and just cut it out as an actual shape. Have a go at this, have a go at the Friends logo, see which one you like the most, okay? I will throw some more difficult ones on next week for you. Here you go. So you can either have a curved edge one, or you can have a straight edge one. Both of them look quite smart, okay? All right, thank you. Good luck.